Hi everyone, how's it going? This is Ash and welcome to my latest video. Today I'm going to be reviewing another Irish gem that's joined my fleet, and this one is a GM181 class in the Ian Road Erin orange and black livery, which is my favourite colour scheme of the Irish rolling stock. This is a Murphy Models commissioned locomotive through Bachmann. If we just turn the box around, it says on the side MM0187 class 181 IE orange, and the fleet number is 187 as previously mentioned. Now, as a golden rule with opening boxes, I always tend to keep a ruler handy, as opening the boxes is much easier this way. So let's see what we've got inside. I hope you're having a great week, as it is weekend almost, or at least at the time this video was made anyways. And just like I promised, I will cover the instructions and the accessories this time, because I did miss those out on the last review of what I've did of B141. And the 181 class, as explained on these details, was introduced in 1966, just 4 years later from the 141 class. But likewise, here is all the information and all the details. Well, that's the information card dealt with. Here is the instructions, complete with all the part numbers as shown on the left, and the locomotive is shown in exploded form on the right. As you can probably guess and know by now, very informative instructions. And on this side, this just tells you about the DCC fitting, which is on this side of the paragraph, and also how to fit a speaker if you wish to add sound to this model. And also further down there is two switches for the tail lights and the headlights if you wish to use this locomotive in multipole. So I have managed to get it right this time and include the instructions. And I will go through the accessories, but I will point out I have fitted some of the parts to the model prior to doing this review. But here is your little bag of accessories, which includes full-fledged air dams, brake pipes, chain link couplers, and some other bits and bobs in there that you can add to the model if you wish. And if I just tilt the box forward, here is the Beast 187 in its full view. And I do have some new rolling stock that I will be running with this locomotive when we commence with the test drive. Now I'm just going to remove the locomotive from the box. And you may notice in the background I have done some more work on my Mark IIIs that I am repainting into the Ian Road Erin orange and black livery. And I will go more in depth with those a bit later on. And here is the Beast. You've got the red front with the orange headlight clusters with the silver frames. The fleet number or road number is 187. Nice amount of weight, but bearing in mind this is a lightweight engine. And if I just place the box tray to one side, I'm just going to remove these foam bits to show you the locomotive in more depth. Just being careful not to damage the potentially fragile handrails. Just get rid of this foam and I shall bring the Beast back into view. And there we go, my favourite livery. This is an absolute stunner of a locomotive. Unfortunately, The horns are a little bit fragile, as I've had to glue them into place, as when I applied them with the tweezers, the pivot ends, which slot into the cab, actually snapped. And it looks like I'm going to have to repair this horn again, as I had to undertake a repair on this end earlier on. But likewise, I'm just going to place the model on the track. I shall undergo the little repair now, and then I will return in a moment with some close-ups and then a test drive when I return. So stay tuned, I shall be back in a moment. And a warm welcome back. As you can see, I have carried out a repair on the fly, which, thanks to the Loctite glue, which is just in the background, I definitely recommend this stuff if you need to repair anything on your model trains. But likewise, sticking on topic and with the review, here is the Beast 187, which is the newest Irish locomotive to join my fleet, which makes my grand total of 9 locomotives now, since I got my first ones in 2011. And without further ado, let's have a look at the front. Just going into 2x zoom. If I just place my thumb here, you should see that the model has sprung buffers. I try not to get my thumb in the way of this demonstration, as I like to show what this model has. Just like with 141, I have fitted the front vacuum brake pipe to both ends to improve the model. As previously mentioned, the fleet number, or road number, is 187 in the striking orange and black enrolled Erin livery. And here is a view of my newest acquired Irish rolling stock, which is a Craven's buffet car, or a snack car, whichever you prefer to call them. A standard class Mark II and a Mark II generator coach, which is in the background. I will confess that I do need a Mark III generator coach for my homemade repainted Hornby Mark III's, which is just behind 210. But meanwhile, again sticking on topic, the model is very nice for detail, but in terms of the quality of the external parts, Bachmann has kind of let me down this time, as I have ended up re-gluing the horns onto the roof, but apart from that, it's still a great model. It's in my favourite livery, and all the eye candy and detail pretty much speaks for itself. So, likewise, without further ado, let's start with the test drive. The 201 class, which is in the background, is 210 River Erne, or the River Erne, whichever that is pronounced, and that shall be passing your screen in a moment, once it gets running. Once the train is cleared, I shall just whisk that screwdriver out of the way. As tools are not really videogenic. And I shall just pan the camera to show more of the track. So, for a nice change, I have gone for an orange theme today, with the 201 on the inner line, and the 181 class on the outer line. As I've previously mentioned in other videos, I do intend to get some more of these orange and black liveried Irish locomotives. which will be an 071 class, as I do want one of those in this colour. And some other variants. So I'm just going to increase the power to 40%. As this is a brand new locomotive, which I did import direct from Ireland, by the way. As this locomotive was an eBay purchase, and I'm very happy with the model. I thought I'd mention a query about reviewing rolling stock, as I tend not to review rolling stock much nowadays, apart from locomotives. The reason being is that I'm not sure how popular rolling stock reviews are as opposed to those of locomotives that I've done since around 2009-2010, as I do tend to cover units and locomotives, but if there is any interest, I can do separate reviews of my coaching stock as well. But I do apologise for the cut in the video there, as I had to reattach the Mark II generator coach, which is just passing the screen. But likewise, as I was saying, the reason why I haven't really done any dedicated rolling stock review videos is the fact that I'm not sure if there's any interest in reviews of dedicated rolling stock. But by all means, if any of you would like to see me do some reviews on my Irish rolling stock or any of my coaching stock that you see in my locomotive reviews, just feel free to leave a comment and let me know. And I have to say, looks like we've lost the generator coach yet again. So I'm just going to go and recover that whilst we're live on the video. Right, should have everything now. Let's see how we do. But as I was saying, I am open to requests. And if you want to see any of my rolling stock that you see in the test run videos on the test trains, just let me know and I will gladly do a review. But likewise, we have been filming here for about, I think, 5 minutes, which will probably be less than that once I've edited the video, but likewise, it shall be time to swap the camera around to another position after a couple of more passes of the two trains, just to keep the video interesting and lively. As you can see, my Mark III's on the 201 hull train on the inner line. I'm not yet finished by quite a way off, as I do need to tidy up the lining and also to tidy up the areas where the white paint has leaked under the window frames, as the Tamiya masking tape was kind of not as flush as I would have liked it to have been. But once I've tidied up these coaches, I shall do another progress, which I will include into another review, or maybe do a standalone video of the complete project that I'm undertaking with these Mark IIIs from start to finish, and post that in a separate video. But I just thought I'd show you all what I've been up to in regards to doing my own Mark IIIs, and I will tidy these up in due course. But likewise, sticking on topic with this review, this view should show a front on and both sides of 187 hauling its brand new Irish Cravens and Mark II passenger train, of which I do plan to get some more Murphy Models Mark IIs, as I would like a set of six plus the generator carriage to run with my rolling stock. Also, you may notice that the lights on this locomotive are quite nicely illuminated. To me, personally, they're not too bright and they're not really too dull either. But sometimes they can dazzle my camera, as my camera doesn't really like bright lights very much. But from this angle, as I have placed the camera slightly further away from the layout, so far, and touch wood, as they say, there hasn't been any dazzling yet. Also, we have been filming in this position for just over 4 minutes, so I'm going to allow a couple of more passes or so, or at least to allow the trains to clear the filming zone, and then we shall place the camera to its final position, of which after that it will be time to wrap up this review and test run of the Bachmann Murphy Models 181 class, which is 187, with a final score and verdict. Although you will see 210 with a front and side view in this angle on the inner line, I hope that this position will show 187 moving away from the camera And also it should show how bright the tail lights are, as I have left the tail lights switched on for the benefit of this review and test run. Just to show the brightness really. Overall, it is a great model, and I would like a couple of more of these models in the same colour but with different fleet numbers, just to add some variety to my Irish fleet. And I do intend to get the super train version, which is similar to this colour scheme but minus the white stripes and the IE logos. So we'll have to see how the quality of that model prevails, as although I do like the detail on this model, the fragile horns when applying them with tweezers, as I tend to use modelling tools to handle delicate parts like this, are a bit brittle, which did result in me reattaching them with superglue. So I'm afraid I will not be giving this model a perfect 10 because of this defect, which I have to say is a bit of a letdown, but I will give it a fair score at the end of the review. As I am a fair reviewer and I do like to cover all aspects and the features on these models. Well, we've just been filming here for over 3 minutes, so I shall allow a couple of more passes, or maybe just over that. Then it will be time to wrap up this review with my final score and verdict. Well, I do hope you've enjoyed this one, as it is a fantastic, nicely made model. It's just a pity that the horns were too brittle for applying with normal methods, which did result in a couple of repairs. But it is a nice model, and I do like the performance. And as you know, I think this model hasn't been ran much before, as it is starting to respond better once the driveline and the gearing is bedding in. But sadly, Bachmann kind of let me down with the detail parts this time. So, unlike 141 that I've recently covered, I will give this one a 9 out of 10. If the horns were more robust when fitting, I would have given this one a perfect 10 out of 10 as well, but likewise, I am a fair person, and a 9 out of 10 is a justified score for the model. And that concludes my review. Well, it's time to wrap up this review. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to post them in the comment section below. And thank you for watching. Have a good weekend, or have a good week. And stay tuned for another video coming soon. Take care, and thank you for watching.